no forgiveness without blood. So even the first covenant was inaugurated with blood. For when Moses had spoken every command to all the people according to the law, he took the blood of calves and goats with water and scarlet wool and hyssop, and sprinkled both the book itself and all the people, and said, "This is the blood of the covenant that God has commanded you to keep, and both the tabernacle and all the utensils of worship he likewise sprinkled with the blood. Indeed, according to the law, almost everything was purified with blood, and without the shedding of blood, there is no forgiveness." New Testament, Hebrew 9:18-22. Beyond this point, I cannot pass. The God of the Bible is a bloodthirsty monster who can only forgive based on the amount and purity of blood. In God's economy, blood is the only currency that matters. Your faith, hope, and charity mean nothing without the blood that purifies all things. God does not save you because he sees your faith. He saves you because he sees the blood that was shed on your behalf. So it was from the beginning. Once outside the garden, humans were required to offer blood sacrifices. The sacrificial system was in place long before Moses, who merely institutionalized it. Christianity rests on the idea that Jesus represents the ultimate animal sacrifice. From beginning to end, status with God was predicated on spilled, innocent blood. This is a point worth emphasizing. It couldn't be just any blood. It had to be innocent, pure blood. The animals could not be blemished in any way. The people sacrificing the animals could not be blemished. And Jesus was the most pure and innocent of them all. Otherwise, his blood would not have been acceptable. A particularly dreadful aspect of Jesus as sacrifice was that his bones had to remain unbroken. This was very important to Matthew. The sacrificial lamb couldn't have any broken bones, so the story was told to have Jesus die before the executioners could break his legs like the others being crucified with him. It is a gruesome little plot device that highlights the fact that Jesus was the sacrificial lamb in a way that would be familiar to the Jewish mindset. He was perfect, pure, and innocent. You see, he had no broken bones, so his blood could be used like the best of the animals. The entire enterprise of Christianity is based on blood. It is not just cult-like. It is a cult in every way. It is a deal breaker. I'm out.